fans, welcome into another edition of Trudel's Weekly Take presented by Health Alliance. We're inside the Owens Center where the team is practicing this week, and with Coach Jean-Guy Trudel, I'm Andrew Mossbrooks. A little more relaxed than usual right now.
This is really nice, actually. This rink is kind of home for me. In the summers, I have all my camps, and when I coach my junior team, this is what I was every day. So a lot of work is put in the office, so I feel just like at home. It's awesome.
There you go. And you're obviously putting a lot of work in this week. The team's coming off a 6-0 win, which is great, but now it's back to business. No more one game a week, and I don't even know the next time that we only play one game in a weekend. It's either 2 and 3 the rest of the way.
And we want that. I mean, we kind of had a slow start game-wise when it comes to the season, which I think it was good when new guys, it takes a while to kind of put that foundation together. So it was kind of schedule was kind of perfect for us. Started a little slower game-wise, and then after that, now we're getting in the bulk of the season. We have Christmas coming up, but after that, lots of 3 and 3s, which I think it's always good. You kind of see the character of the guys when chips are down a little bit, when you're tired a little bit, when legs are heavy, see what kind of strength between the years we have. And it's always good to play 3 and 3 just to see those little things.
Basically, a 3 and 3 is kind of a form of adversity. You're going to be dealing with that a little bit Friday night because that 6-0 win is great over Quad City. The caveat to it is Jake Hamilton is suspended for a game. Take me through a little bit of that, maybe your reaction to the suspension. Did you know right away?
No, I knew a few days. The league does a good job of sending it a few days later. So a few days later, I got the email, told Jake, and we understand. For us, it's not going to change the way we play. We're a big believer. We're family, and if something bad happens during the game, we're going to be there to protect each other. We want everybody to feel really safe when they're out there, understanding that they have teammates, brothers behind them doing what they need to do. So here there you take a suspension because of it. You don't want to see that fighting, but sometimes you got to do what you have to do to make sure our leading scorers like McCormick or a goaltender like Eric Levine, that they can play comfortable without worrying about that physical kind of aspect of the game.
And I feel like we talk about Levine, and we've certainly talked about McCormick all season long. I don't know that we talk a lot about Jake Hamilton. I think maybe we should. Obviously, he's going to be out of the game Friday, but he's got 11 points on the year. It took him over 30 games to get there last season. He had 11 in 11 to start this year. I think Jake Hamilton's taken a big step forward in year two.
Yeah, I had a chance to talk to him. He came, he had a camp with Alec Agerman this summer, and I had a chance to talk to Jake and make him understand that last year was great. He did a good job last year, and he was more of a defensive defenseman, but he knows the way we like to play now. He knows that I need a lot from my defensemen. My defensemen need to be jumping into play all the time, and he's one of them. And with that success at the beginning of the year, I gave him power play time, and he excelled on that also, and it's kudos to him. I mean, he came a long way. I remember him he got away from the college game, came to the pro game last year as a rookie, raw rookie, sent him to the Federal League for a few days, came back, had a phenomenal attitude, and he's another one of, we talked about Dion, about Hageman, about Scroves, about all those guys that have that old school mentality. For sure he does. He's not playing in the right era, but he's doing a lot of great things for us here in Peoria.
What about another player that we probably don't talk to or talk about enough? I was just talking to him, Alec Bear. He started the year with Evansville. He's been so good and a reliable 200-foot game. He's great in the dot. What does Alec Bear bring to the team?
Oh, he brings so much. When I it seems like me and Jeff there in Evansville have a pretty good relationship right now, working on what's needed on both sides. And I've seen Alec. I was watching tape on him, and I worked for about two and a half weeks to get him in a trade. And finally, Jeff really needed that defenseman, and I really needed the center. And after seeing that kid play, even in Evansville, which Jeff or himself didn't think they played their best hockey, I still saw a lot of great things in Evansville. And when I made that trade, I knew I had a winner. I mean, you don't get a point a game in the dub without being a talented kid, being a smart kid. Major junior is a completely different animal when it comes to learning the game of hockey and playing the game of hockey right. So especially in the dub, which it seems like every player that comes out of there have a great foundation of how to play hockey the right way. And when we got him, it completely changed our game around, because then we could put guys in the right position. We put Alec back on wing where he strives. It really opened up a lot of great things. And then we had Niemann that came in as a third centerman and actually is doing a phenomenal job for us. So Bayer was an absolutely for us, it's I was lucky for some good trades over my years, but that one was really what we needed at the time.
Something I want to ask you about, because it's certainly relevant with our team. This team has 15 fighting majors in 14 games, and the way that the hockey community has kind of responded to fighting as it's sort of going with the dinosaur in other leagues at other levels. I want to know what your opinion is on fighting and the relevance it has in the game, and Is too much fighting, is there such a thing as too much fighting? Does it oversaturate the meaning it has in a game?
I don't think it does. If you look at our fights this year, it's never a fight that we just fought to fight. I mean, it's a fight usually to protect our goalie, or a fight to send a message that that's not going to happen again, or those type of things. And as a coach, you don't ever ask, because I always say this, as a coach, I will never ask somebody to go fight. Mm-hmm. I need some, you know, sometimes you know you need a spark, sometimes you know you need a little bit of a, you know, I call it of a momentum changing shift of guys going physical on the forecheck a little bit more. But as for fighting, for us, it's, I think most of the fights come in a protective way. We want to make sure, like we talked about earlier, that we know that we have certain players that, you know, their job is to score a lot of goals or make a lot of saves. So for them, they have to be protected and they have to feel comfortable, because I was in two different scenarios with different teams that my job was actually to score, you know, score the goals and be an offensive guy. And when you feel, when you go out there, when you're that offensive guy, your name is always on the board from the other team saying be physical on that guy. When you get to be, some guys get to be really physical on you and you play those guys a lot of times and you don't do anything about it, well, it's like a bully bullying somebody. Yeah. They're going to keep bullying. So, and it, which is absolutely normal. So I think our fights are more into the fact of protecting our brothers, protecting our family, to make sure that those things don't happen again.
One of the things you mentioned right at the top there is protecting your goaltender. And right now your goaltender is red hot. Eric Levine has shutouts in back-to-back games, 55 straight saves. He's 7-0-1 on the year. You know, I usually ask you this all the time, who's going in net this weekend? And before it would be, well, we've got Jeremy, we've got Eric. Is there any chance Eric gets both games?
There is a chance, yeah. We're going to start the first night with Eric, and there is a good chance. Dylan's looking really good. I thought the last 2 days, you know, a long travel coming in. And still, we play a certain way, and for us, we play a certain way, goaltender out. We, you know, we work with our goalies every single week to make sure there are certain things that we like done, and I think he's playing a lot better the last 2 days. He's set a lot more. He's a little tighter as a goalie, and we're going to keep working with him. There's a good chance, but all we know, to be honest with you right now, you never know in hockey. You know, an injury or this or that. So for sure, Friday, Eric is going
to
be in net.
And you have to be prepared, because this Evansville team is red hot right now. They're outscoring opponents 22-9 in the last four games.
Yeah, and I'm happy for Jeff. I mean, he unfortunately, when Jeff got to Evansville being a year, he didn't get his protecting list wasn't great from last year. They struggled a lot last year, and I think he really turned that team around. I called him during the summer, and I told him how great of a summer he had recruiting wise. I think he did a great job of bringing a lot of guys of talent in there in Evansville, and it just like us a little bit when you have new guys. We were fortunate that things fell into place a little quicker than them, but it takes a while to build that foundation, build that, you know, kind of that cohesiveness between all the teammates and new teammates, new faces. And right now he's doing a good job, so I'm happy what he did in the past. This weekend, hopefully it doesn't happen, but I'm happy for him. It's, as a coach, I know how hard it is, and when you get, I was there as an expansion coach here in Peoria. That first year, the first month and a half was a struggle, you know, trying to find the right players, the right balance. So I'm happy for him, but this weekend we're going there with a, you know, one goal in mind, and that's the win Friday night, and then we'll take Saturday when it comes, but Friday's going to be a big one for us.
I think this is going to be a weekend of some really good hockey games. It's against Evansville on the road in the Ford Center. Friday and Saturday, both games with a puck drop at 7:15, but that's going to do it for this edition of Trudel's Weekly Take. Coach Jean-Guy Trudel, thank you and good luck.
Thanks a lot, Andrew. Appreciate it, buddy.